Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Distinguished guests, esteemed colleagues, good morning. Anisayo. It gives me great pleasure to present to you some of our strategies related to sustainable growth in addressing challenges that are considered global in their nature. So I'll try to make this as fast as possible. So just to give you an overview about Qatar, as you can see from the map, it's quite a small country. It's around 11,500 kilometers in size. The population as of 2016 is 2 million. 12% is only Qatari nationals. The majority are short-term migrant workers. There are a number of opportunities and challenges that Qatar currently is facing. With regards to opportunities, we are registered as having the world's highest GDP per capita, abundant energy resources related to oil and gas and solar. We've got national commitments since 2006 to build a knowledge-based economy with a dedication of 2.8 of our GDP in R&D. The World Cup 2022 and major project, which is considered also as a challenge, not only as an opportunity. Some of the challenges that we are currently facing, of course, one is to diversify from the hydrocarbon economy. As per our records, more than 60% of our economy is related to hydrocarbon. The recent drop in oil prices led to decline of our GDP by 20%. It also has impacted many projects related to R&D. So this is one of the challenges we're facing currently. Only 2 days of water reserves, and the majority of the water that we currently use is through desalination. A lot of R&D related projects to come up with innovative ways to provide water resources is taking place. 90% of our food supplies is imported. 1% of land area is under cultivation. The World Cup, as I have mentioned, is also considered as one of the challenges. Lack of science and technology, human critical mass is one of our major challenges. It's also one of our strategic objectives to build the capacity in South Qatar. Latest statistics in 2013, as we conducted by the UNESCO, has registered to have slightly more than 2,000 full-time equivalent researchers in Qatar in 1 million population, which is something we're trying to build. It has been doubled since 2008, but currently we're trying to come up with different alternatives to increase the number of capacity related to R&D. Now, just to give you an overview about the evolution of Qatar's R&D, we're quite nascent. We started in 2006 with the government commitment of 2.8 of GDP in R&D. At that time, we didn't have R&D experience or culture at Qatar. During that time, also, Qatar National Research Fund, which is the national funding agency, got established with the main vision to build research infrastructure and capacity. In 2008, through the national vision, government committed transforming the economy into a knowledge-based economy. Through QNRF, many funding programs got established. One of our flagship programs is the National Priority Research Program, which I will be talking about later on. It helped to establish a research infrastructure and capacity inside Qatar. In 2012, we got a very important milestone in which Qatar Foundation R&D got established as a governing body for research institutes, QNRF, and Qatar Science and Technology Park. Since 2010 and 2012, we had three national research institutes that has been established. We got the Qatar Energy and Environment Research Institute, the Qatar Computer Research Institute, and the Qatar Biomedical Research Institute. Also during 2012, we published the Qatar National Research Strategy that helped propel our research agenda forward. In 2013, we had our five-year integrated R&D business plan applying implementation of the National Research Strategy. In addition, later that year, we defined our three grand challenges, water security, energy security, and cyber security, handled mainly by the two research institutes. And later that year, 2014, later on, we defined for the biomedical and health our grand challenges related to cancer, personalized medicine, diabetes, and cardiovascular. During 2014 and 2016, and later on between 2015-16, with the drop in oil and gas, we had to come up with a new strategy to focus our research and investment. We established international partnership and MOUs to help address challenges of common interest. And we focused mainly also to support with innovations, streamline and monitor Qatar's R&D activities through grant challenges. One of the biggest opportunities that I would say can help in addressing our grand challenges through global interaction is the baseline that has been set through the National Priority Research Program that been started in 2008. And through it, a lot of collaboration got established. As you can see here in the graph, Qatar publications were very minimal since 1984. By the time with the announcement of the NPRP during 2008, the number of publications, even 40, has increased tremendously. You can see the percentage of international collaboration as of 2014 increased to 89% of the publications. Lately, 2016, a report came by Thomson Reuters looking at the landscape of Qatar. And through it, they have highlighted that the citation footprint is becoming has increased and is becoming above the world average and surpasses the global cooperation, Gulf Cooperation Council. Just to give you an overview about the ecosystem within the Qatar for R&D, science, technology, and innovation. We fall under Qatar Foundation umbrella. There is the Qatar Foundation R&D, which is, as per the definition, we define the Qatar National Research Strategy, our policies. They facilitate, monitor, and evaluate research activities. They have two arms. One is the enabler arms, which is Qatar National Research Fund, which we fund research to address Qatar National Research Strategy. We've got the Qatar Science Technology Park. We're supposed to facilitate, they are supposed to facilitate innovation and transition of ideas into market. They are a hub for incubating ideas, and they are also tax-free. We, as QRF, we're paperless. Everything is used through online systems, starting with the application till the close-out of the report. And the same applies with Qatar Science Technology Park. Currently, we're undergoing the QRF R&D to come up with a national information system that will connect all the R&D activities inside the state. We found the different research institute, Qatar Energy and Environment, Qatar Computer Research Institute, Qatar Biomedical, in addition to the different universities, ministries, and private companies. As I mentioned earlier, the Qatar National Research Strategy helped define our national strategy when it comes to research. They fall under four pillars, the energy and environment, ICT, biomedical and health, and social sciences, arts, and humanities. Just recently, we've been transformed our strategy to become focused to our grand challenges, as I mentioned, energy, water security, food security, environment, health, and cybersecurity. We're trying to create optimal value and impact, becoming more outcome-driven investment, complement support existing R&D mission area. Cross-border cooperation in science, technology, and innovation is becoming a very important instrument for countries around the world to address key challenges that are key challenges within our time. These key challenges, they best address through cooperation between the countries. And knowing that, realizing that, we establish programs that jointly fund areas that are of common interest regionally and globally. Some of these programs and activities include joint calls with common research areas. We have joint workshops and conferences. We have research experience exchange programs. In addition to this, we have different activities that promote research topics and connect researchers, such as partnerships and MOUs, network activities, other types of workshops and collaboration. Currently we are a member of Belmont Forum. We launched the call last year in climate change, and this year it's going to be in sustainable urbanization. In March, just a couple months ago, we hosted a workshop in collaboration with the European Commission to connect and define areas that are of interest in sustainable energy and energy security between the European and the GCC countries, and to come up with a joint call to address that. We had also joint call in infectious diseases with NIH to address it within the MENA region. We have other calls that are currently in the process to address other areas that are of interest. There are exchange programs to build capacity in South Africa. What we are lacking, I would say, at this time, and we're trying to address, is to actually fund this strong collaboration within the MENA region and the GCC country. There are still not yet a body that help in connecting all of the GCC and MENA region to come up with areas that are of interest, because what we are currently have, especially in the Middle East, there are topics that are of common interest within the Middle East that is probably different from the global, such as society security, cyber security, and other topics that are of interest within the MENA. We are a member of the Global Research Council, which are to talk and bring in dialogue to address some of the challenges related to that. Finally, just wanted to show you, this is a couple of years ago, shows the research facilities to support our agenda available at the foundation. Now it's completely finished, and two of our research institutes has already moved in. There have been more facilities that are designed to serve institutes and meet the needs of researchers from universities, industries, and international collaborators. There are a long way for us to go, but currently we're trying to come up with the best approaches that we use internationally to address the needs of Qatar and the region globally. With this, I conclude my presentation. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr.